Let my mouth be filled with your praise,
that I may sing aloud.
My lips shall shout for joy when I sing to you, Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's be aware of the grace and goodness of God. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, restorer and lover of innocence, direct the hearts of your servants towards yourself, that those you have set free from the darkness of unbelief may never stray from the light of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Some who had come down from Judea were instructing the brothers, unless you are circumcised according to the Mosaic practice, you cannot be saved. Because there arose a little discussion and debate by Paul and Barnabas with them, it was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and presbyters about this question. They were sent on their journey by the church and passed through Phoenicia and Samaria, telling of the conversion of the Gentiles, and brought great joy to all the brethren. When they arrived in Jerusalem, they were welcomed by the church, as well as by the apostles and the presbyters, and they reported what God had done with them. But some from the party of the Pharisees who had become believers stood up and said, "It is necessary to circumcise them and direct them to observe the Mosaic law." The apostles and the presbyters met together to see about this matter. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
Let us go rejoicing
to the house of the Lord. I rejoice because they said to me, "We will go up to the house of the Lord." And now we have set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem.
Let us rejoice in the house of the Lord.
Jerusalem, built as a city with compact unity, to it the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
Let us rejoice in the house of the Lord.
According to the decree for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord, in it are set up judgment seats to the house of David.
Let us rejoice
in the house of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and everyone that does, he prunes, so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Anyone who does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them, throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Remaining in Christ means that there's some things we're going to have to let go of, and maybe some things we need to embrace. That's that pruning. God cuts back areas of our life and things out of our life that, in a sense, are in communion with him. That don't Christ. And if we remain in Christ, great things are going to happen. And so sometimes we have to let go of our own will, our own way of seeing things, our own way of doing things, so that in the sense that Christ can be the essence of all that we are. And so this day, what is it that Christ might be asking of us to let go of or to embrace, so that we can be in his presence and in his goodness and richness, and he can fill us with the joy that he wants. Let's ask God to help us see what that might be. And we bring our needs to our gracious God. For all of our baptism in the church, may the grace of our baptism and our participation in the life of the sacrament strengthen our commitment to Christ and the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who exercise leadership on the world, national, and local stage, may the power of the Holy Spirit guide them in service to their people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and all in need of God's healing this day, may the hope of the resurrection bring them strength. And may God look graciously upon them in their need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, may the Spirit of Christ continue to nourish us and help us to bear fruit for the kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died, that they may share the glory of the Father. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bring our own needs to God. For these needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we entrust these our prayers, knowing that you will hear them and grant them according to your will. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, with your ministry of this bread we offer to the fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, with your goodness we have this finally offered to you. Through the divine and all from your hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, far and at the good of all his holy church.
Grant your prayer, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paths and mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our heavenly joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit,
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, and duty our salvation at all times to pray to the Lord. But in this time of all, the lives you get are glorious in Christ our pastor as a sacrifice. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies over what the Lamb was slain and lives forever. Therefore, overcome, cast a joy every day, and every deed results in your praise. Even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together in the name of your glory, as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and your willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks for it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave thanksgiving to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, to celebrate from the world of death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, that throughout the world, we went to the fullness of charity and given with Francis, our Pope Gerald, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints of Egypt throughout the ages. We may marry to be the heirs of eternal life, and to glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the sacred command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us from the evil, gracious and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of your apostles, he said to you, my peace I give you, but God of our sins, and of the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
give peace to those next to you. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, bless the fall of the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
thank you. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.